Walt Disney's Carousel of Progress. Well, you're in for a real treat. The Carousel of Progress was Walt's own idea from beginning to end. He loved it. He introduced the show at the World's Fair in New York City in 1964, and it was an immediate smash hit. Millions of people came to see it. And since then, the Carousel of Progress has had more performances than any other stage show in the history of American theater. You know, Walt loved the idea of progress, and he loved the American family. And he himself was probably as American as anyone could possibly be. He thought it would be fun to watch the American family go through the 20th century, experiencing all the new wonders as they came. And he put them together in a show called Carousel of Progress, which we are now about to see. Although our Carousel family has experienced a few changes over the years, our show still revolves around the same theme, and that's progress. May the century begin.
There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow is just a dream away. There's a dream that's the start, and follows a dream, mind the heart.
Patricia? Papa, all these people. I'm indecent.
Don't worry, Patricia. teenage daughter. She's getting ready to go to a Valentine's dance across town on one of those new horseless trolleys. By 9 o'clock, daughter, you hear me? Oh, well, with all this talking, I've worked up quite a thirst. I think I'll take one of those newfangled trolleys down to the drugstore soda fountain and meet the boys for a cold sarsaparilla. Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot. We're drinking root beer now. Same kind of thing, different name. Well, that's progress for you. And speaking of progress, there's a great big beautiful tomorrow. Shining at the end of every day. There's a great big beautiful tomorrow, and tomorrow is just a dream away. Man has a dream, and that's the start. He follows his dream with mind and heart. And when it becomes a reality, it's a dream come true for you and me. So there's a great big beautiful tomorrow.
Century over 20 some odd years ago. You know that pilot fellow, Charles Lindbergh? He's about to fly a single wing airplane all the way across the Atlantic. He's never gonna make it. And sports stadiums are springing up all over. And boy, nobody hits that old horse hide like that new fellow Babe Ruth. Jazz music is the cat's meow. And there's been ads in the paper for months for a movie starring Al Jolson. He's going to talk and sing. Oh, boy, I've got to see that. There goes Schwartz in his Hummobile. He sure loves that horn. You know, in my new Essex, I've got an electric starter. Now I don't have to crank. We can travel from New York to Los Angeles by train in only 3 days. And we've got a house full of new electrical servants. Mr. Edison sure added life to our home. Well, there you blow a fuse. Crap, that's the third one this week. I buy fuses by the case. Uh-oh. And I blow the whole neighborhood again. Easy, Rover. Jimmy, hurry up with that fuse.
Shucks, every time he has company, he blows a fuse.
I guess he always has to change it.
I heard that, young man. I heard that. Sarah's Ladies Club is responsible for our town's 4th of July celebration tonight. She's got us all roped into performing in their program,
and I decided we're going as George and Martha Washington.
Oh, the father of our country. That's a role that really fits me. You know,
I'm so glad we installed an electric light procedure on the porch, because it's just too.
Yes, Sarah. You know, next year I'd like to go as Benedict Arnold, and Rover, don't interrupt while Sarah's interrupting.
And guess who volunteered to choose the
music for the program? I did, Pop. Listen to this.
Oh, that's a nice tune, Jimmy. You know, with our new Crosley radio set, we can get news and big-time entertainment from all over the country, even Pittsburgh.
We're starting to arrive downtown for our spectacular 4th of July parade and fireworks event.
Oh, Patricia.
Yes, Father?
Better get a move on. The radio says folks are arriving downtown.
Do I really have to go? If my boyfriend sees me in this, he'll
scare him
away.
Oh, dear. If that happens, you'll always have that torch you can carry for him. Calm down, Rover. I was only kidding. By the way, we have indoor plumbing now. Oh, boy, that's really great on cold nights, especially for our perennial house guest, old Uncle Orville. Uncle Orville's taken over the coolest spot in the house, of course, and he's rigged up a real clever contraption. He calls it air cooling. Too bad he's not reading the help wanted ads.
No privacy at all around this place.
Sorry, Orville. You know, considering all the... Oh, coming, Martha, as I was saying. Considering all the conveniences we now have, I'll say that we're really on Easy Street these days. It just can't get any better. Just goes to show that
there's a great, big, beautiful tomorrow shining at the end.